Well, as soon as Ariana sang, I was like, oh wow, this is a song. This is serious.
One of the biggest challenges was this song with Ariana Grande, which we need the song to save humanity. So we knew it was quite the high challenge.
I love, love, love working with Nicholas Britell. We have a lot of the same favorite like sounds. I just love how he paired these orchestral strings with these electronic sounds. He had this orchestra and was pairing it with these super modern like plugins and sounds, and I respect him so much, and we had so much fun writing the song.
On paper, you can say, oh cool, so it'll be a love song, it'll turn into a thing, but to actually pull that off is very difficult, and it's not obvious at all. And so I was truly indebted to Taura for figuring out how that would happen.
He described it as being a song that starts off like a love song, but ends in disaster. So then I heard Ariana's melody, and it was like so beautiful. There was no shortage of inspiration because of what was going on in the world. And when things come together like that seamlessly, it was like, okay, this is happening, this is meant to be. The words flew out of me.
It was this really beautiful collaboration. So I laid down this early sketch of the song. Ariana then recorded a whole top line over it.
Well, one of the things she started doing in that first session was she started improvising these lyrics for the end of the song about how that comet's coming. And watch out, because we're all gonna die. And it was hilarious. And right away, I was like, leave that in the song.
So once Adam explained who Riley and DJ Cello are in the film, and it was like, oh, okay, you know, just let me just go to TMZ for a little bit of inspiration. Even in the midst of COVID and the surges, we are really still focused on who's getting divorced and who broke up. It seems so ridiculous, but that's how ridiculous we are. No, I let you down, I need you tonight. And there's
so much you could lose, and yes, that matters. Yeah. I've been thinking with madness, yeah. When Nick Patel first played me the song, I was blown away. Ariana's voice is so beautiful and so soft and sweet, but powerful. So I just kind of thought about myself kind of elevated in this realm and having this relationship with another huge celebrity.
There was a particular sound that he was looking for, and I think, you know, I mean, he's such an unbelievable performing artist himself, and I think there's a sense of the sound in his mind, in his mind's eye and ear, of what he was looking for as Kid Cudi, as well as DJ Cello.
This is not Kid Cudi per se. This is Cello singing and begging for forgiveness. So that's how I approached it. I just kind of went in the mindset of Cello and went from there.
It's that fine line where it is Ariana Grande and Kid Cudi. It's Riley Bina and DJ Cello, but it's Ariana Grande and Kid Cudi. So we have to, all those elements are at play.
The part where she says, we really fucked it up this time. We really fucked it up this time. That was really dope. I wasn't expecting that when I first heard it. I was like, oh, so I see where this is going. This is cool.
And I'm like, whoa, so I can curse, yay. You know, you don't get a chance to do that often, and cursing with a purpose is okay. It was really much art imitating life, imitating art.
As long as we're following the storytelling, as long as we're accomplishing what we need to for the film, my take is then always like, well, it also has to be the best it can be, you know? So I think we always push ourselves to make sure that we're giving our best and we're, you know, putting forth something that can stand on its own as well as in the film.
It was such a fun thing to be a part of. I can't believe that I got to do this. It was so cool.
On-camera songs are so much work goes into them. I think sometimes, you know, when they work, they should feel totally seamless and just a natural part of things, but they're actually one of the most involved parts of, certainly of working on music for a film. Just look up.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.